I bet that at most points in your day, you're within sight of clean drinking water. Just look around you. That's not the case for a billion people around the world who lack access to safe drinking water, or the million people a year who die from water and sanitation-related diseases. In 2010, the United Nations recognized access to safe water as a basic human right. Now you might ask, Canada is abundant with fresh water, and these problems don't exist here. Well, in 2015, Canada had 1,800 drinking water advisories, including 170 on First Nations reserves. While the United Nations recognizes safe water as a basic human right around the globe, many of our fellow Canadians still don't have this necessity. Water can be filtered using membranes, and it can be disinfected using chlorine or UV treatments. But these treatments don't work when there's organics present in the water. Organics create four treatment challenges. They foul filters, they add color, taste, and odor to the water, they provide food for bacteria growing in underground pipes, and the fourth challenge is that organics can react with chlorine to form cancer-causing compounds such as chloroform in our drinking water. Ion exchange works like a water softener in your home. It removes organics and releases chloride ions. And this works really well for organics removal. But after a couple weeks, the filter becomes full and there's no space left for further organics removal. Now, these filters can be regenerated to regain space for organics removal, but this process creates large amounts of very salty waste containing all those organics that you just removed. And disposal of this waste is a problem for small, remote, fly-in communities. My research is using naturally occurring bacteria to consume the organics attached to these filters. During biological ion exchange, the organics you see here in yellow are adsorbed to the filter by normal ion exchange mechanisms. Once attached, bacteria growing in these filters break down these organics and use them for energy. Eventually, a steady state is reached where organics are being consumed at the same rate that they're being destroyed, and these filters can perform indefinitely without the need for that salty waste-producing regeneration. In accordance with the United Nations Declaration for the Right of Indigenous People, Canada has pledged to solve all drinking water problems on First Nations reserves by 2021. In most of these cases, organics are going to have to be removed from the water before chlorine or UV treatment can be installed. Canada is gifted with beautiful water resources, but the quality of life of many Canadians is still dependent on their access to safe drinking water. Biological ion exchange offers low maintenance, robust, and low cost means for safe drinking water for all Canadians and people around the globe. Thank you.